السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله سبحانه وتعالى in the Holy Quran in Surah An-Najm says, فلا تزكوا أنفسكم هو أعلم بمن اتقى. Don't purify yourself and attribute purity to yourself and praise yourself. Allah knows who has taqwa. Allah knows best who is more pious than the next person. In another place in the Holy Quran, لا يسخر قوم من قوم عسى أن يكونوا خيرا منهم. That do not mock at another person. Perhaps the person whom you are mocking is better in the sight of Allah, where it matters most. And one trend that we find that people mock and judge people with regard to their past actions. This is highly contentious. Perhaps a person has done something that is wrong in the past. However, he might have made tawbah. He might have repented. And in that particular way, for us to judge and mock at him is something that is not correct. Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in a hadith in Jami' al-Tirmidhi, "Man ayyara akhahu bi dhanb," whoever taunts a person because of a guna that he has committed and he has made tawbah, you would not die until you do that very same thing. Let us take the example of Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. If you're going to judge people on their past, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu set out to assassinate Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Can there be a greater sin? And yet, today, he is in the proximity of our beloved Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He became Al-Faruq, Umar fil Jannah, Umar is in Jannah. There's a very interesting incident written in a kitab, The Laughter and Smile, The Smiles and the Tears of Our Beloved Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam. A person, a sahabi by the name of Dihya, came to our beloved Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was an influential person. And when he came in, he said, "Ya Rasulullah, I want to accept Islam, but I'm worried whether Allah will accept my Islam or not." So he said, Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Innal Islama yahdimu ma qana qabla." Don't you know, O Dihya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through the means of Islam, wipes away whatever you have done in the past. So Allah will accept your Islam and all the guna of the past will be wiped away. He said, "Ya Rasulullah, do you know what I have done?" And then he said, when he said what he had done, "I had buried 7 daughters alive." Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam sat stunned until Jibreel alayhi salam came with a wahi and said, "Ya Rasulullah, if Allah can wipe away through the means of Islam his kufr and disbelief, why can't Allah ta'ala forgive and wipe away this deed?" Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam cried and said, "Ya Allah, you can wipe away the sin of Dihya, but what about the sins of my ummah who read the kalima la ilaha illallah?" Just imagine, after burying 7 daughters of Allah, we still say, radiyallahu an. Don't taunt a person with regard to his past, especially if he has repented.